Leadership is a conversation so much about action, exerting influence, making decisions. And I would just submit a little mind flip. What if we spent just as much time cultivating a successful inner life? What if we spent just as much time being really sure about what our true values and purpose were, developing emotional resilience and equanimity to deal with all the change and turbulence in the world? Now, that's not what success looks like on CNBC, but I would argue it's a real source of advantage, and more importantly, a real source of fulfillment. Second point. It's increasingly important to develop the disciplines and the habits of mind of artists, even if you don't think you're an artist or close to an artist. Why is that? Well, I talked to Dan Wyden, who's the co-founder of Wyden Kennedy, the guy who wrote Just Do It, and I said, what does it mean to be a leader of a creative, thriving organization today? And he thought about it for a minute, and he said, you know what? I think my job is to walk in stupid every day. Walk in stupid? Why? Well, something overnight, no matter what industry you're in, has changed. And it's your job to forget everything that made you successful, to forget that experience curve, and to cultivate the inexperience curve, to walk in without all those assumptions and with the fresh eyes required to attack a new day. Final point, probably the most important point I've ever learned about leadership. 15 years ago, when we were starting Fast Company magazine, my co-founder, Alan Weber, would always say, you know, a good question beats a great answer. And that just got seared into my brain. Funny thing happens when you go around the world listening for questions instead of answers. You realize, actually, that a lot of people are much more interested in giving you answers and asserting their opinion, especially business people, than asking questions. But why does inquiry beat certainty? Well, questions are a powerful antidote to hubris. Asking genuine questions immediately opens up curiosity, humility, even vulnerability. And in this world of expanding complexity and constant change, it offers a real advantage. If you're the kind of open person who's going around asking questions, you attract more perspectives. You surface more possibilities. You engage more people to your cause. Now, Vineet Nayar, who's the CEO of HCL Technologies, the huge Indian outsourcing company, carries around with him a list of 20 questions I ask myself every day, and he really does look at it every day. There are questions like, what if my company or no company in the world had a CEO? What if we threw out the rule book? Is my company the kind of company I'd want my kids to work at, my employees' kids to work at? He doesn't claim to have the answers to any of these questions, but they're important to ask. They are the bedrock of all creativity, all curiosity. And the great thing about questions is anyone can ask them. Anyone who spent any time with a three-year-old knows it's really easy to ask why. Why not? What if? Just start asking those questions every single day. And if I leave you with anything, I would ask you, when you go back to your organizations after this incredible three-day event, try to walk in a little bit more stupid and with a lot more questions. Thank you so much.